Welcome everybody to another video of Ancient Greece Reloaded. Today we will talk about the famous Chryses, the woman that was the beginning of the rift between Achilles and Agamemnon during the Trojan War. Moreover, in our next video we will talk about Briseis, the woman that actually caused the rift between Achilles and Agamemnon during the Trojan War. By the way, if you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel so as to stay tuned for upcoming videos. In Greek mythology, Chryses is a Trojan woman, the daughter of Chryses. Chryses, her apparent name in the Iliad, means simply Chryses' daughter. Later writers give her real name as Astynome. The poet Zeus describes her to be very young and thin, with milky skin, had blonde hair and small breasts, 19 years old and still a virgin. As the Golden One, she is also the title-given character of the Baroque alchemical epic Chrysidos Libri 4. Mythology. Chryses would be resident of the city of Thebes, a city of east of Mount Ida, and it was in this city that Chryses paid homage to Apollo. The city of Thebes would be ruled by King Eetion, the father of Andromache, and Thebes was thus an ally of Troy. Chryses Astynome was sent by her father for protection or, according to others, to attend the celebration of a festival of Artemis in Hippoplakia and Thebes or in Lernesus, where she was taken as prisoner by Achilles when the city was taken by the Achaean forces. According to some, she was the wife of Eetion, king of Lernesus, usually described as the ruler of a nearby Cilician Thebe, who was killed by the son of Peleus during his campaigns against the allies of Troy. In the first book of the Iliad, during the distribution of the booty brought by Achilles, she was given to Agamemnon by an anonymous decision in view of his kingly office. As a war prize, Agamemnon, who admitted that she was finer than his own wife Clytemnestra, enslaved Chryses and refused to allow her father to ransom her, even though the priest of Apollo offered the Mycenaean king gifts of gold and silver. Thus, Chryses left the Achaean camp alone, but Chryses then called upon Apollo to avenge him, and of course Apollo listened to the prayers of his priest. Hence Apollo, in the darkness of night, came through the Achaean camp and unleashed his arrows, brought down a plague upon the Achaeans, and the army was thus decimated by disease. Agamemnon would call upon Calchas, the Achaean seer, to explain the plague ravaging his army, and of course Calchas revealed that the plague would not lift until Chryses was returned to her father. This of course was not what Agamemnon wished to hear, and Agamemnon called Calchas a prophet of evil, but nevertheless Agamemnon was forced to heed the words of his seer, and Agamemnon agreed finally to return Chryses. But there was though a proviso, that Agamemnon would need a prize equal to Chryses, and there was one such prize already in the Achaean hands, for Achilles had taken the beautiful Briseis as his own prize, and so even as Odysseus was returning Chryses to her father, when were being sent to take Briseis from Achilles. Such an act was unworthy of Agamemnon, and an indignant Achilles would refuse to take to the battlefield again, with devastating impact upon the fortunes of the Achaeans. After the attack on Rhesus and his Thracian armies, Chryses came to the Greeks to thank them for returning his daughter Astynome. Because of this kindness and because he knew that his daughter had been properly treated, he brought her back for Agamemnon to have. A later Greek legend, preserved in Hyginus Fabuli, states that she had a son named after her father by Agamemnon. In the city of Thebes in Asia Minor, Chryses gave birth to Chryses and declared him to be a son of Apollo. This took place when she was released shortly as a prisoner and allowed to return to her hometown. A few years later, when the children of Agamemnon, Orestes and Iphigenia, took refuge in the island of Smithnos, now the home of Chryses and her family, she proposed surrendering the fugitive to King Thoas. Her son Chryses, learning they were his half-siblings, helped them to kill the Taurian king. In medieval literature, Chryses is developed into the character of Cressida. Let us finish with the following saying: everything in the past is judged by the outcome of the last event, Demosthenes. That being said, remember guys to hit the like button and to subscribe to our channel, it would help us a lot. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for upcoming videos.